Welcome to what is potentially part 5 of Project Phoenix, the Fiat Coupe 20 valve turbo rebuild. There's a fly. I would just like to say a big thanks to the people that have helped me out so far on this build. You know who you are, people. I'm very grateful for everything you guys have done for me. So I've got some new parts, some new bits have arrived, some expensive parts. Now my bank balance needs to recover slightly so that we can carry on, because I've got some more stuff to buy yet. Still missing off the list of things we need to get is a new core for the turbo, a cam belt kit, need to sort that out. A sunroof would be good also. It's not high on the list of priorities. Let me show you the new bits. And then let's have a new working total, because we haven't done that since episode 1. So let's have a look at the stuff we've got. Now, you've seen this, I'll recap the other stuff and the total somewhere. And I'll show you the new stuff right now.
There's the wheels, there's the interior, consoles and switches and stuff. But there's a box there in the middle with some other bits and bobs in it. I just want to go into a little bit more detail about what these are.
Some important parts have turned up. A MAF sensor, we definitely needed that. Injector clips, we needed those. And a turbo. I'm going to put a new core in this one because it's a bit ropey, but, you know. Look how tiny it is. Very small. If we compare it to this one. This is the T28. And this is much bigger. But that's for another day. The next piece of the puzzle missing. Intermediate drive shaft. Complete with bolts. Also excellent. And a good bearing. Also a downpipe there. Excellent.
So that gave us a total of £379 so far.
Now I know I had a red one and a blue one, but now we've got a yellow one. It's right. And the door trims as well. I know it's a little bit of extravagance, I know that. But they weren't horrifically expensive, and it was good. It was good. So there we go. We have new trim pieces. Brilliant. And I've got some new bolts for the calipers.
And brake calipers. Yes. Now we can stop. Or we should be able to.
In good condition. The nipples are free. In fact, they're loose, which was a prerequisite in buying them. Are the nipples free? He said yes, they come with the calipers. Two calipers. If you're on the Facebook group, or possibly Instagram, I've already put this up there. We've got this. A MotorQuip clutch. MotorQuip, there's the part number. But it's actually a Valeo clutch, as they all are, anyway. Which is great. Next on the list of new parts, we've got a header tank. Yes, and a bit of pipe work. Excellent. I have given it a courtesy clean out. There is a rice trick you can use, isn't there, with rice, but I have tried that before, it didn't work out very well, so I just got about 50 M6 nuts and chucked them in and gave it a good shake, and it's cleaned it up pretty good. That's not bad at all. This was also one of the gifts that I've had for this build.
Thank you very much. Mr. Ives, thanks. It will be well placed. Let's put it on. Let's put it in its place. There is a space there. There is a screw there that I've already put that on with. And there is one under there too. So that's where that's going to live. Brilliant. Look at that. We're getting a busier engine bay.
Adding those totals up to our previous total of 379, we now get to £829. It's getting expensive now. But remember, if you'd have bought this as a rolling shell to reshell another one, you'd already have these parts anyway. I've still got to get a turbo core, timing belt kit, service kit, and whatever else that I've forgotten that I'll go, oh yeah, I need one of them later on at some point. Wish me luck.